Namaskaram. Indian classical dance, in any form, is essentially a stylized representation of the myriad hues and experiences that we undergo in our lives. And underlying this representation is a very colorful and beautiful language of gestures and movement. For what is beautiful about Indian classical dance is the way in which it seamlessly integrates the different movements of the arms, the feet, the head, the eyes, and so many other parts of the body to communicate meaning. Swathi Soft Solutions is very proud to present as part of its Sanskriti series, Hastas and Bhedas, an introduction to the fundamental principles of movement and gestures that are used in most classical Indian dance forms today. Presented here is an introduction to the Asamyuta Hastas, the single-handed gestures, and the Samyuta Hastas, the double-handed gestures that are used in classical dance, along with some of their most important applications. Also presented is an overview of the movements of the major and minor limbs of the body, along with select applications. The references for this production are taken from the Abhinaya Darpana and the Natya Shastra. While traditionally, any Indian art form, be it dance or music or anything else, is best learnt under the guidance of a competent teacher, a guru who has learnt and experienced for himself and herself, and who is then suitably equipped to transmit this teaching to other students. This product is intended as a very brief bird's eye view into the multiple layers that constitute the edifice of Indian classical dance. We hope that this production will be the first step in your journey towards understanding the beauty and depth of Indian classical dance.
Patakastripatako ardhapataka kartari mukha mayurakhyo ardhachandrascha arala shukatundakaha mushtischa shikharakhyascha kapitha katakamukha 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 suchi chandrakala padmakoshas sarpashirastatha mrigashirsha simhamukha kangulascha alapadmakaha chaturo bhramarashchaiva hamsasyo hamsapakshakaha sandamsho mukulashchaiva tamrachudastrishulakaha.
Pataka hastaha. The word pataka means flag.
When all the fingers are joined and stretched,
and the thumb is bent and held at the base of the forefinger. It is known as pataka. Pataka hasta viniyoga.
Natyarambhe vari vahe vane vastu nishedhane kuchasthale nishayancha nadyam amaramandale turange khandane vayau shayane gamanodyame pratapecha prasadecha chandrikayam ghanatape kavatapatane sapta vibhaktyarthe tarangake vithi praveshabhavepi samatvecha angaragake atmarthe shapate chapi tushnim bhavani darshane talapatre cha khete cha dravyadesparshane tatha ashirvadakriyayancha nripashreshthasya bhavane tatra tatreti vachane sindhau cha sukritikrame sambodhane purogepi khadgarupasya dharane mase samvatsare varshadine sammarjane tatha evamartheshu yujyante pataka hasta bhavanaha.
The pataka hasta is used to depict the following: the beginning of dance, clouds, a forest, forbidding something, bosom, night, river, heaven, horse, cutting, the wind, to lie down, to go, prowess, favor, moonlight, scorching sunlight, to open a door, the seven case endings, ripples, entering a street, equality, to anoint oneself, to indicate oneself, taking an oath, silence, a palmyra leaf, shield, to touch different objects, benediction, to indicate a king or ruler, to denote such and such a place, the sea, succession of good deeds, to address somebody, going forward, holding a sword, month, year, rainy day, and to sweep. Tripataka hastaha.
The word tripataka means three parts of a flag.
When the ring finger of pataka is bent, it is known as tripataka. Tripataka hasta viniyoga.
Makute vrikshabhavepi vajre tadharavasave ketaki kusume dipe vanhijvala vijrambhane kapote patralekhayam banarthe parivartane yujyate tripatakoyam katito bharatottamaihi.
Tripataka hasta is used to depict the following: crown, a tree, a thunderbolt, to indicate Indra or the one who bears the thunderbolt, the Ketaki flower, a lamp, leaping flames, a pigeon, to write, arrow, and turning around.
Samyuta hastaha.
Anjalishcha kapotascha karkata swastikastatha dolahasta pushpaputaha utsanga shivalingakaha dolahasta pushpaputaha utsanga shivalingakaha katakavardhanaschaiva kartari swastikastatha katakavardhanaschaiva kartari swastikastatha shakatam shankha chakrecha samputa pasha kilakau matsya kurmo varahascha garudo nagabandhakah khatva bherundakakhyascha avahit
Anjali Hastaha. The word Anjali means salutation. If the two pataka hands are joined at the palms, it is known as Anjali. Anjali Hasta Viniyoga.
Devata Guru Vipranam Namaskareshwanukramat.
Anjali Hasta is used to depict the following: offering salutations to God, the teacher, and to the learned. Kapota Hastaha. The word kapota means dove. If two pataka hands are held together so that only the base of the palms and the tips of the fingers meet, with the joint palms creating a hollow, it is known as kapota. Kapota Hasta Viniyoga.
Pranami Guru Sambhashe Vinayangi Kriteshwayam.
Kapota Hasta is used to depict the following: salutation, addressing one's preceptor or teacher, and humility. Karkata Hastaha. The word karkata means crab. When the fingers of both hands are interlocked and turned inwards or outwards, it is known as karkata.
Karkata Hasta Viniyoga.
Samuha Gamane Tunda Darshane Shankhapurane Anganam Motane Shakhon Namane Chaprayujyate.
Karkata Hasta is used to depict the following: the arrival of a crowd, showing the stomach, to blow into a conch, stretching one's limbs, and pulling down the branches of a tree.
Swastika Hastaha.
The word Swastika means a cross. When two pataka hands are crossed at the wrists with the palms turned outwards, it is known as Swastika.
Swastika Hasta Viniyoga. Samyogena Swastikakhya Makare Viniyujyate.
The Swastika Hasta is used to depict a crocodile.